Everybody, good day to you all. Welcome again to another video on my channel. Happy Sunday to you all. So I'm very sorry, I have to apologize. This video is coming a little bit late. You know, I'm a family woman, I have children and also other things on the side. So I was supposed to bring to you this update that happened on the 3rd of June. Recall that my last video on Sotitobi Restraya resumed on the 2nd of June. So I promised you guys that I was going to bring this update to you as it happens. And so this video is an update on the continued trial of Sotitobi Re, the pastor of Sotitobi Re Miracle Center in Akure, Ondo State, in the case of the missing baby girl, Enila Loluwa. And the trial continued, as I promised you, on the 3rd. And this video is just to give you that update. So if you are joining me for the first time, please subscribe. Don't subscribing, hit that subscribe button. Thank you so much for doing so. And I want to say thank you to every one of you who already subscribed, who joined recently, who has been coming all along the way. Thank you so much. I really appreciate your support for me. So yeah, the court proceeding started, and the prosecution continued with bringing in their evidence, and they happened to feature 4 of their witnesses, and the witnesses presented the evidence that they had against Sotitobi Re to the court. But Sotitobi Re's lawyer fought really vehemently against one of the evidence that was brought in as the confession of one of the women who worked in the baby crèche on that day. And at the end of the day, they lost that battle because the court allowed the evidence to be used as evidence against Sotitobi Re. So for whatsoever reason they fought against that evidence, I don't know. But anyways, the counsel to the parents won that argument, and the judge has admitted that evidence. And that evidence was actually the confession of the people who worked in that crèche during the time of the DSS, Defense of State Security. You know, they came down from Abuja to arrest these people. They were actually the ones who initiated the arrest, because the local police and the security personnel in Ondo State did not arrest anybody, did not even initiate any trial. So the DSS arrested them, and they made some confessions. It is these confessions that they are trying to use as evidence against Sotitobi Re in this court trial, and Sotitobi Re's counsel are fighting against this evidence. So I'll just let you hear what Sotitobi Re's lawyer has to say, and then I will continue.
What we had in court was the continuation of trial. The prosecution called the 6th witness, who is evidently the last but one, and after calling the 6th witness, also applied for an adjournment to enable them to call the last witness. And the Honorable Court, of course, obliged, more so that there was no objection from the defendant. The matter was adjourned to Monday for continuation of hearing. So we expect that on Monday, at the grace of God, the prosecution will call the last witness and close their case for defense to open.
I don't know why they are fighting against those confessions that they made, because the DSS people said they did not force them. They gave those confessions in good faith, and they followed the protocol, that they didn't give the statement under duress. So the court accepted the evidence. So that is going to be used as evidence against Sotitobi Re, and the counsel to Sotitobi Re, they are not really, really happy about that. And another thing is the correctional facilities are not even allowing any access to Sotitobi Re and his people that are also arrested alongside with him. I don't know why that is, and the lawyers are not happy with this situation at all. They are saying that next week, after the prosecution is going to present one more of their witnesses, then the defense will start. They will need to present their own case, and they complain that they need access to their client, who is Sotitobi Re and his members. Now he needs access to them so that they can prepare for their defense. So he has not been able to get that permission, and we don't know how. Maybe in the next hearing they will have that permission to have that access to his clients, because maybe he needs to visit them and sit with them and have conversations. I don't know the kind of access that he is wanting, and why they are rejecting it. And to be honest with you, I find this thing very, very interesting, because normally somebody that has a large following like that and something happens, you know, he should be able to gain some kind of a bail so that he will be coming from home. But it will be very, very serious for him not to be granted bail, because either the DSS and the state prosecution have a very, very solid case and evidence against him, or they are afraid of the outrage of the Akure citizens. So recall what happened before he was taken into custody. You remember that the people were so angry that they went to that place and tore it down and, you know, decimated that area, and even some people lost their lives in the process of that chaos that happened that day. So I don't know if the judge or the state prosecution are afraid of the outrage of the people if he is allowed to go on bail, you know, like the people sensing some kind of unfairness, or, you know, justice that is not free and fair, you know, because he's a notable person, he's a relative to the king of Akure, and yeah, he has politicians who are also his members. Yes, he really has a large following. So I don't know why it is possible for them to detain him without any bail and without any access to his counsel. So this thing is really, really serious, and it's really, really getting interesting. So on the whole, I would like to ask you guys if you would still want me to bring any detail, or should I just allow the court proceedings to go on a little bit so that when something significant happens during the court process, so I can bring you the news. I don't know, you can tell me if you write it in the comment section so I know how to proceed going forward, because right now the case has been adjourned again to Monday, and that is tomorrow, and the prosecution still has one witness that they are going to present to the court, and afterwards the defense, that is Sotitobire's lawyers, will now start their own defense, you know, trying to refute every claims and every allegation that have been laid against him. So that is basically what the defense is going to be about. Recall that this baby was taken to his church on the 10th of November last year, and up till this date, this baby is still missing. And upon the missing of this baby, he didn't take charge and try to help in finding this baby. Instead, the parents of the baby was lied upon that they hid their own baby. They wanted to use him as a black me to collect money. All this turned out to be false. And to cut a long story short, the DSS came from Abuja and did the arrest. And in the process of this arrest, you know, they arrested also those people who were working at the crèche that day. It's really incredible, because all of them said the evidence they gave is that they all went to throw away trash when it happened. But I have this clip where a group of women who said they were there on that day, and yeah, even though they spoke Yoruba, they said that they were there on that day and they saw the mother coming with a baby in the company of another woman, and then at some point the other woman came and took the baby, you know. So for me personally, I'm not buying that story, because you don't just give somebody's baby to anybody. You don't think and give somebody baby who they're asking you to take charge of the baby, and you didn't let the person confirm from the mother. You know, in this jet age, you can just place a call, you can do so many things. So anyway, they said they saw the lady who took the child, and I don't know the evidence that they are trying to hide from the court, that the parents lawyer fought her to get the court to admit it. But here is a video of this lady saying this thing I just explained to you now.
Oya sisara robe when children class kilo shele lojo na.
Okay, ni ojo yen bo bo se bo mo yen de awon awon meji lo bo mo yen wa ni ojo na.
She ri won,
mo ri won.
Kani afika ni
bo mo yen de iya olomo ati eyan ko lo gbe wa. The next 5 minutes o wo pada wa. O wa gbe o wa fun mo yen ni omi ati onje. Bo se lo ni yen. Next 5 pa pada wa, iya ni omo da omo da omo.
I saw you.
Accurate.
you can hear them. They are saying that the mother came in the company of another woman and she knew that woman, and the other woman came and took that baby, and then the mother of the baby came back and said she didn't know who that woman was, that she didn't come in company of that woman, and she's kind of basically denying that she knows the woman. But the mother is saying that in her own account she said that she didn't come with anybody, that in fact they were telling her to go and drop the baby, and they have been telling her, and then she made up her mind to just drop the baby, and she met that woman they are talking about there, and she actually thought she was one of them. Also, there's this interesting video that I think you should see, because this video is a conversation that happened between the president of the Christian Fellowship of Nigeria, PFN, and a reporter, a local reporter, and this reporter was narrating the story of what happened inside the church according to what the mother told the police, because you know we haven't heard this part of the conversation, so I'd like you to hear this conversation.
So Tito Bire is not a member of PFN, his church is not under PFN, neither can say also say, and I don't know other places that it has happened again, but I'm saying that they are not a member of PFN at all.
Yes, on the let me just speak you on the issue of carelessness. All right, the story we have stated that the mother, Mrs. Mutupe Kolawole, to take the child to children department. All right, got in there, she dropped the child there, and went back. Prayer session was on.
Okay.
She did not close her eyes.
Okay.
But it was at a point that the GO asked everybody to close eyes, and even stated that if you don't close your eyes, that such person, or if anybody doesn't close their eyes, that such person will die before end of this year. I mean, the Mutupe Kolawole had that, close their eyes. Even we learned that the general officer came to stand beside her. All right. And the woman closed her eyes, praying, the prayer points. It was that period. Immediately after the prayer points, she went back to the children's section, and the child
was missing.
Oh yes, no, we have to be found again.
So basically, this is just to give you some glimpse of what is going on, what has happened previously. But we don't know exactly the details of what the evidence is, and we are going to see how the defense will go, and we're going to wait for the judge to evaluate all the evidences and the refutals before him or her, and make up their mind on whether to charge guilty or acquit the accused. Until then, I pray for the parents. I pray that God Almighty will console them, give them the strength, and help them in these trying times. My heart goes out to the mom. This is her only child, her first child. I don't know what she's going through, but I know that God Almighty in his infinite mercies will be with them and help them and deliver them. And they also said that everywhere they went to pray, that they got the message that the baby is alive. So on a rare occasion, I would like to really believe that at this point in time, because I can't imagine anything happening to this beautiful baby. So I'm going to go with them on that and keep my faith up with them on that, and trusting God that the baby is going to be found and everything will end. Praise. So this is my own position at this moment, and I would like to ask every one of you to always remember this couple and this baby in your prayers, and we'll see how the case continues next week. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, like this video, and I'll see you very soon tomorrow or next, bringing you the next update. Thank you so much for watching. Bye for now. Bye.